Hello everyone. I am Mustafa Seçmen, the head of the Department of the Electrical and Electronic Engineering of the Yaşar University. In this presentation, I want to give some information about our graduate programs. Okay, not only the our graduate programs, also the all the programs in Graduate School of the Yaşar University. Tries to train the good engineers and tries to provide the research-oriented academicians and the qualified professionals, the engineers, to the universities, research centers, and the research and development departments of the companies, firms, with its education given in the international standards. These are the our graduate programs related with the engineering in Yaşar University, and the bold ones are the ones in our department of the electrical and electronics engineering. We have a PhD program, we have a master program with thesis, and a master program without thesis or non-thesis. You can see the our academic staff in these slides. Our department contains academic staff whose research areas, research subjects, and the subjects that you can work in your thesis or in your master or PhD program is varied too much. You can see that the research areas can vary from the control system to the electromagnetic embedded systems to the machine learning, the from wireless communication to the optical system, the physics, the biological systems, the artificial neural networks, signal processing, the power system, analysis, power quality, and energy management, the automatic control optimization, and the industrial automation, robotics, and the process controls are the main subjects of the our academic staff. And these are the some possible research areas that you can focus on in your master or PhD education. And this is a good summary table about the differences between the PhD, master with thesis, and master without thesis. You can see that master without thesis is a more compact program, a short duration program, but it is a number of courses higher. There is no real thesis in this program. There's a short term project and there is no seminar course. But the PhD and the master with thesis are the more academic programs that the academic novelty is supported by the some application is needed, especially for the PhD program and also partly for the master program with thesis. And you can see that in all of our program, we have two compulsory courses, but we have several elective courses that you can select according to your research area, research subject. And you can find the details of these courses in the course plan given in the last row of this table. Okay, about the scholarship in our programs, you can see that all the PhD students or the candidates, including international applications, can get full scholarship if they are accepted to our PhD program. It's not only specific for this, our electrical and electronics engineering program. It is also valid for all other PhD programs in Yaşar University. I will explain the requirement to get this full scholarship in the next slide. For the master program in our department with the thesis, also for the international students, there are some opportunities for the scholarships such as the Turkey scholarship that you can. Okay, for the international students, you can see the our application websites. There are also good details about the minimum requirement for the application and other supportive information such as the fee of the each program. So for each individual program of the third of the three lines that you can see for the PhD, MS with thesis and MS without thesis can be applied through these websites for international students. Okay, before applying our programs, I and our department staff highly recommend you to look at our thesis subject proposals, especially if you are planning to apply the our PhD and the master program with thesis, because these are the subjects of the academic staff written in this website. So if you want to study, if you want to focus on a research area, you can also connect with the academic staff whose working area or research area is coinciding, is same with your desired working area. So it is highly recommended, it is critical to look at these thesis subject proposal. And in this website also there are some opportunity of the research projects such as the international one or the national ones or the from the university supported projects listed in these websites. The above one is the for the English version, and the below one is the for the Turkish version. But in this project, even the international students can get some financial support by joining or participating in this project as a students working on this project. So it is advised to look at these subjects, thesis subject working areas of the academic staff and the possible opportunity for the project participation. And the in our programs of the master with thesis and the PhD, the ones where you will write a thesis, we have some publication requirements. In the first line, you can check the publications done by the graduate students of the Yaşar University, including to our department graduate students and the academic staff. The requirements to for the graduation is written as the in the below site. For the master with thesis, you should have a one accepted conference paper, or you should have one submitted journal. And for the PhD, you should have a one accepted journal and one submitted journal. For the MS with thesis, one of them is enough, but for the PhD, both of them should be satisfied. Okay, for the more informations about the processes and the frequently asked question, you can check these websites of the, our graduate school of the Yaşar University. There are some good information, extra information and the explanation about the, especially the process when you start the PhD or the master with thesis. And these are the our department's graduate program websites and contact information, email for our department and the graduate school.